Hello, my name is Conor Hughes. I live in Blackrock, Dundalk, and I'm a volunteer with Crosscause. For 10 years now, Crosscause, with the help of this locality, has been funding humanitarian projects, in particular in Romania, and in particular with special needs orphans.
Every year on Stephen's Day in Blackrock, County Louth, Crosscause organise spectacular fundraising events. Generous donations raised on the day go towards their projects in Ghana and Romania. Since all Crosscause volunteers are self-funded, every donation goes directly to those in need.
The core strength of the charity has been its volunteers. They've come from all walks of life with one single thing in common, and that's a desire to improve other people's lives for the better.
Twice a year, volunteers load an aid truck for the people of Nicarest. The goods donated all positively impact on the community.
Hi, my name is Claire Colvin and I was a volunteer with Crosscause in Castlebridge at Nicarest from 2003 to 2007 on a full-time basis. During my time there, I saw Crosscause and Castlebridge extend its walls to become a home for 16 vulnerable young adults which we rescued from state-run institutions. Not only did I find my experience of volunteering at Castlebridge an eye-opener, but also hugely rewarding as I watched the 16 residents adapt into their safe new home and life. For anyone who decides to travel the road to Nicarest, I'm sure they will find it an equally rewarding and life-changing experience.
Many lives have been changed in this community in Nicarest. And here at Casa Brigid is where the Crosscause story in Romania begins.
The project in Romania is called Casa Bridget, St. Bridget's House. The name was given to honour the people locally who funded it and who gave up their time to construct it.
Hi, I'm Claire Malinti and I've been living in Nicarest as a volunteer since 2007. Casa Bridget is our group home for special needs residents. It was set up in 2003 by some Irish volunteers who come out to volunteer in the local spital. The spital had over 100 children in horrendous conditions. Their lives have transformed since coming to Casa Bridget. Casa Bridget is their home and we try to give them everything they need, from love, affection, a balanced diet, medical care and a warm, safe environment. Some walk that weren't able to before, some can talk that weren't able to before, they can dress themselves and they can feed themselves, all express themselves in different ways, and our work hasn't stopped there. They are still learning new skills and we're constantly trying out different activities, different games, different life skills with our residents in the hope of making them as independent as possible and give them a fulfilled and happy life well into the future.
The residents of Casa Brigid go for regular walks with their carers and volunteers. And this not only provides a form of exercise, but it also raises a positive awareness of respecting people with disabilities in this community. The day centre was set up in 2007 to try to break the cycle of poverty in this village through education.
My name is Grina Rousseau, I'm 15 years old, and the foundation helped me first time when I was little. Seven years old, I start coming to day center. After the school, I used to come to day center to have something to eat. And after that, for 2 hours, we stay in the class, and the teacher teach us to read, to write, and that may help us.
Sadly, many children in the village finish school at 14. As the nearest high school is 20 kilometres away, and many families cannot afford the monthly bus ticket for the children. So the foundation supports these children to continue their education, and generous donations help to pay for their monthly bus ticket to the nearest high school in Tekuch.
I'm now in high school in Tekuch, in class 9. Which wouldn't have been possible without the foundation. I have a new dream for my future. I would like to go to university in Ireland or England, and I would like to travel the world. In the future, I would like to be a volunteer and to help people like the foundation helped me. If I will do this, I know I will make proud many people, and I will be very happy. For me and my brother, the day center was very important.
Hello, I am Yonel Melinte and I live in Casa Ion. I remember Pauline who came to me and with a lot of volunteers and connected my house back to the electricity, give us food, send us to school, and my sister to the day center. Now I help my wife to run the charity, so this work is very important, especially for the village, because here is very, very poor people, and without the charity help will be very difficult.
The charity supports many families in Nicoresht and nearby villages.
And the families here really need the support and donation from the people in Ireland.
Life is tough in this area, and harsh winters make everyday life a struggle for the most vulnerable in the community. Crosscause volunteers help the local community in whatever way they can, and they go to great efforts to deliver food to where it's needed badly, to the most needy and vulnerable in the villages. Yet there is hope as one home is fed. However, in 2014, many families and elderly here are still without running water and electricity. And they have used this water for basic needs. At this time of year, many homes are inaccessible to vehicles. So food deliveries are made on horse and cart. And these goods sent from Ireland are delivered to really grateful families.
When my parents died, I had to go to placement center. After 1 year, me and my brother was very happy to come to Casa Ion. Casa Ion is a house built by volunteers for my family. Now we have a mom and dad, Claire and Anel.
We try to give our children everything they need, from love and affection and a well-rounded education. We hope to show them a better way of life than what they are used to, and to give them great aspirations for the future.
So the charity changed my life, and they make such a difference to me and my family. Thank you everyone which has made part of that project. Thank you.
The foundation really helped me, and I'm very thankful to everyone who supported me over the year.
And finally, I thank all the volunteers whose passion and stories have inspired this video.
This film is probably the perfect opportunity I have to thank the locality, all the volunteers, and all the people who have trusted the project and have trusted me in particular to relay their generosity to the less well off, to trust the charity's judgment in helping the most in need. I never take for granted what people have done in this locality to help us, and how they have taken to their hearts the work, and I hope they feel that we've done them proud.